welcome back. And if you have children at home, you might put them in front of the TV set right now. My good friend Kim Pittman is here. I haven't seen Kim for a while. And she is the executive director of the Greenville Humane Society. And she has brought so much enthusiasm and talent to this particular organization. You've meant a lot.
Well, it's always a privilege to come visit you.
And I have to tell you that we have a puppy dog dressed as Santa Claus, and he's going, Santa Claus is going to sleep. Look at this.
So he is so sweet.
Oh, he's adorable.
So we had a cute little group from Greenville Tech Charter High School.
Yes.
That had come just before I came on the show. And I said, what should we name him? I'm going on the Peggy Denny show. And so they all came up and they decided that his name would be Rudy, short for Rudolph, in honor of Christmas. But I wanted to do my shout out because they brought carts and carts and carts of much needed supplies to the Humane Society. So they did a fantastic drive for us, which is so appreciated.
Okay. Now, we have a phone number and a website we can put up. And the Humane, you have many, many animals that need a home.
Absolutely. We have 5,200 adoptions a year. Oh. We are actually proud that Greenville has embraced the model. We're the largest no-kill facility in the entire Southeast now, right here in Greenville, in a smaller area than many big cities. So it's a wonderful place. We're proud that we pull animals from 13 shelters that would normally be euthanized, and they get a second chance, and also for owners who just can't afford them.
Now, if somebody is thinking of adopting a pet, and it's, you know, that time of year, you welcome the whole family to come out.
You know, that's what we tell folks. Don't give somebody a gift certificate. Don't give them a puppy that they haven't picked. Make it a wonderful family affair, and we have bonding rooms where your children can come, where you can pick the different animals that you might want to visit with. You can put them down on the floor. You can run little toys and see what their personality is like. This guy's cute, but, you know, what's his personality? And we really encourage families. It's good for you and good for the animal to get the right match at the start of the process.
You have puppies, so nobody stresses out. And full-grown animals.
We have usually 140 animals on the floor at a time in our adoption center, and it's a fun, friendly, energetic place to visit. It's not gloom and doom, and we're lucky that our friends at Irwin Penland and McMillan Pass and Smith designed a fantastic building, and you have been so nice to be there on many occasions.
We love what you're trying to do. I love animals and children, and I've said before, anybody who hurts an animal or a child is in trouble with me.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, that's predictive of them, of somebody not being kind to humans in the future.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's one of the reasons we do a lot of community outreach in the schools.
I know you do.
58,000 people, and we partner with 200 various not-for-profits and schools and churches in the area, and we love nothing better than to talk about responsible pet ownership and to do wonderful classes with pets.
If somebody decides, well, you know, my children are old enough now, they can help take care of a pet, we could adopt a pet. This is kind of the time of year people think about that. Is it expensive?
You know, I always tell folks that our adoption fees are extremely reasonable, but you need to know that this is a member of your family and you're going to need to give it shots.
Sure.
You're going to need to buy dog food for it. You're going to need to take it to the vet on an annual basis.
Yeah.
So it can be expensive, but, you know, a puppy is $125 to adopt, but our adult dogs, those are 4 months and older, are only $50.
All right, but now they come with shots and everything.
This guy has already been neutered. He's already had his first set of shots.
Television has put him to sleep.
He's already had his first set of shots, and he's been treated for fleas and heartworms, and he is ready to go.
Oh,
he is ready. He loves the warmth of your studio. He knows he's in the presence of
so
an animal lover.
Here.
Yes, and he's all wrapped up.
You do need what from people? I mean,
so, you know, we are 100% run on donations.
I know you are.
And we don't get money from the county or from the state or from national humane organizations. So we rely on folks to give us monetary gifts, like we'll talk in a second about Santa Paws and Santa Claus. But folks can do wonderful donation drives. I can get paper towels, newspapers, bleach, hand sanitizer. We've got our wish list on our website. And families sometimes will do that. They'll come in and bring a bunch of presents for the puppies and the kittens and do that as their way of doing something as a family and mission outreach.
So you can always use...
Always.
Food and...
Always can use those things.
You mentioned towel paper?
Paper towels, newspaper, bleach, hand sanitizer, puppy food and can. All those things are always needed for us, and it's a tremendous help. It costs us $10 a day to take care of these babies. And so when somebody brings a gift like that, that helps us put more money towards the animals, and that's what we're all about.
But if you do think of adopting, know that it is a commitment, that when they're little and cute and fuzzy, they're going to grow up. And
absolutely. And that's why we love coming on your show, because you have a big heart, but you're also a responsible pet owner.
He was so adorable before we went on the air. And all of a sudden, he's under the lights, and he's just collapsed.
Say, here I am. Maybe I'll come back.
May I hold him?
Oh, he would love to be in your lap.
Kim, oh, come here, precious. Kim, show us. Talk about this. What
okay.
is it?
This is, a lot of folks say that they have everything they need. And when it comes to Christmas time, whether it's family members or neighbors, that they're looking for alternative Christmas gifts. And this is a program called Santa Paws and Santa Claus. So whether you're a cat person or a dog person, you can do this. These are fabulous cards. These are our own pets. So basically, you're sponsoring a pet at the Greenville Humane Society. The donation could be $5 or more, and we will have a Santa Paws and Santa Claus tree. So you can give this gift to somebody that says a donation has been made in your honor, and they can keep the card and put it on the refrigerator. At the same time, they can go to the Greenville Humane Society, and they'll see their name and their card hanging up on our tree. So it's really, you know, we always say this is the community's Humane Society, and this is fun, festive. The kids love it because it's real animals on our floor who are looking for a permanent home. And it just, you know, it spells out Christmas in a community when you see that tree and loaded with cards.
I want to say something that I know it has happened many, many times. But if you have an animal that you can't keep for whatever reason, don't just abandon it and think, you know, I'll put it out here and some kind person's going to find it and give it a home. Don't ever do that.
Right. Please bring it to the Humane Society. I mean, one of the things that we're so proud of is our puppies will stay on the floor one day. I mean, they stay absolutely no time at all. And adult dogs are only on the floor for 1 week. So if you're feeling bad and you're thinking, oh my goodness, I'm going to sentence my animal to staying in a kennel for months and months, that's not true at the Humane Society. We're good at knowing those animals. We're good at matching them to the perfect family. And we're good at getting them a home very quickly. And we don't judge. We welcome any animal that's a great animal. We love to have that animal on our floor and get it to the perfect family.
So if you can't keep, for whatever reason, don't just assume that you've let it out and somebody's going to pick it up.
But that is a picture right there. Is that not the cutest picture of Peggy? They match. You match.
I think he likes
you. You match. He loves you. He's just snuggled up in your arms. That is so precious. So that's made my day. And I usually don't do Christmas this early, but I'm doing it for you because this is so much fun. So yes, it's very good.
Well, you walked in with him in his Santa Claus.
I couldn't resist. I knew you would go for it.
I had this shirt on. I didn't know anything about this.
I knew you would go for it. I knew you have that kind of heart, so I knew you would enjoy it. A little fun.
Now, you have not only puppies and kittens, but you have older dogs as well, and sometimes purebred dogs.
We do, and I think people are surprised about that. 25% of our animals are purebred dogs. So, for example, I was lucky enough to get a beautiful English chocolate lab. And there's others, you know, German shepherds. We have a bulldog on the floor right now. We've had Weinerammers. I mean, we have beautiful dachshunds, long-haired dachshunds, chihuahuas, shih tzus. You need to put your name on a list called the Best Friend Finder Program, also found on our website.
Now, wait a minute. What, you have a list?
It's a waiting list.
They call up and say...
It's called the Best... I say to folks, this is like the Nordstrom Personal Shoppers for pet lovers.
Yeah.
You put your name on this list called the Best Friend Finder. You say, I want a Shih Tzu. When you get a Shih Tzu, call me. When we get a Shih Tzu in, we call Peggy Denny and say, Peggy, I know you said you wanted this color Shih Tzu, but this one's slightly different, but it's such a great personality. Please come down and see it. That animal is on hold until you get there. You're able to meet the pet. You're able to see if you like the personality and if you feel like it will be a good fit for your home. It's a wee bit more expensive, $175, mm-hmm. but we do the shopping for you because some of those breeds are really hard to find at affordable prices, not at thousands and thousands of dollars.
Yeah, that's the thing. Yeah. I mean, if you are not going to show dogs and you want a dog for your pet, for your family, or a cat, whatever, you don't have to go and spend a fortune. You can find love, yeah, just like this. And an older dog is like, what, 50?
$50. Sometimes
and
even.
And they also come
also
with shots.
Also been spayed and neutered and had their shots.
See,
and
they're ready
and
to go.
Flea and heartworm preventative. I mean, we don't. You know, what we tell folks, our job is to save animals, and our job is to make sure that they go to a fabulous family. But we don't make money on adoptions. We don't make money on adoptions. So, you know, we encourage folks. The other thing that people need to know is we have all the supplies they need to be a successful pet owner. And when you buy from the Humane Society, our prices are 25% less, so you can get Kongs, you can get Nyla Bones, you can get crates, you can get stainless steel dishes, and all that money goes back to help us cover the cost of running an adoption center and also do free community outreach in the program, in the community, which is a staple of what we do,
well,
what we're
you
all about.
You do programs in the community.
We do. We
People,
actively go
now you're
out.
You're located on Airport.
We're located at 305 Airport Road.
Airport
we're right
Road.
Off of Haywood Road.
Yeah.
So right near Haywood yeah. Mall. And again, we encourage, you know, I love to go on a Sunday where folks come after church. They're all dressed up in their church clothes and they're in there in the puppy room. It's like becomes a family outing for everybody to go and see the puppies and hug
and
the puppies
and welcome them
love
to come.
That's what,
no,
you know,
no charge for that.
We are
just,
the community's,
you know,
Humane Society.
Yeah.
We are all about loving the animals, educating people about the animals, and making sure that the animals get a second chance and go to a fantastic home, and then celebrating the fact that they become a permanent member of that family. And pets are really important on so many levels, whether you live alone and you might be anxious or you might be depressed, whether you've got children and you need to teach them responsibility and jobs and chores, that's what happens with a pet, or whether you're, you know, a young professional and you're working hard but you need an outlet, somebody to go running with you at the end of the day. There's nothing better than coming home after a 10-hour day and having some wiggle worm at your door,
waiting,
you know, jumping
you.
Up and ready to lick you. That's what it's all about.
Well, you've done a phenomenal job.
Well, we love it. And we love that Greenville has loved us.
And you do various things throughout the year. We're talking about, you know, holiday now, but all year long you have events, don't you?
We do. We do. One of our favorite events for the entire community is the Mutt Strut. And it is in August. It's always the third Saturday in August. And it is the largest dog-friendly race in the state of South Carolina now. Last year we had 2,000 people and 1,600 dogs. And it was, everybody was well-behaved. It's 2 miles. It was the most fun. Probably my best image from that was an old Basset Hound who got to be in the parade. He was in a wagon with a blanket, you know, gray, but he came across the finish line with his owner while the younger dogs around them were running across. But he made the parade and he was in the Mutt Strut. So it's a, you know, again, Greenville loves their pets. And we're all about a celebration of pets, and we want the Humane Society to be a place that makes folks proud, and we want that to be top of mind when folks think I need a pet, or I need shots, or I found this animal that needs to be spayed or neutered.
And people have different needs. I mean, somebody may want a dog that's big enough and loud enough to scare off would-be.
Exactly.
Trouble.
We have those dogs, and then we have some that just bark a lot, but if you get inside, they would capitulate to anybody who gave them a treat.
Yeah.
But you know, that's our job. Our job is to make sure that the animals that are in our adoption center are not aggressive. We test all the animals that come in. They need to be healthy, and you know, we want to make sure that they're going to be a good fit. If they come from an owner, we spend a lot of time understanding their history so that we can share it with the new owner.
If somebody brings a dog that they can no longer keep,
right,
you find out what the history of that.
Right. It makes a difference because then you, as the new pet owner, will know that that dog loves a Kong with peanut butter instead of a Nyla bone. And so that dog will go into your family and be right at home because you'll know what their favorite treats are, where they like to sleep, you know, if they're good on a leash. But you know, what I last thing I would say is one of the things we're most proud of is we could not run the Humane Society without our fabulous group of volunteers. And
that was my other question. What about young people, high school age? Do you have room for volunteers?
We're very proud that we are one of the few not-for-profits in Greenville where you can be 13 and volunteer at the Humane Society. You might be opening papers, you might be helping fold laundry, you might be picking up poop. When you're 16 and you've been trained by our authorized dog trainers, certified dog trainers, you can walk dogs. We have a whole group of people who have retired that they call it cardio for a cause, and during the week they have groups of friends that come, husbands, wives, friends, walking dogs together. So there's a lot of ways we could not run the Humane Society without the fabulous group of animal-loving people with big hearts, and they have the time, and they know we're so appreciative, and they're what help us get animals adopted. Because if you can walk a dog, and if they've been worked with on a leash, they're going to present so much better when you come to visit with them as a prospective adopter. So somebody's already worked with them. They haven't just been thrown out in a kennel and nobody's tended to them. We're really trying to teach them manners and make them present well so they'll be a good pet.
So now you welcome people, families, whatever, and they don't have to call ahead and make an appointment or anything like that.
No.
Sunday, Saturday?
We're open 7 days a week. We will not be open on Christmas Day. But we close early on Christmas Eve, but we are open 7 days a week. I mean, we are here for the animals, we're here for the community, and you know, our job is to educate and make sure you get the right fit. And we love what we do, and we'd love to celebrate with folks at Christmas time.
And I'm very glad that you have an opportunity, if there are young people out there, particularly high school age young people, that have an interest and a love for animals, and they have time to volunteer.
A lot of folks today need service hours. A lot of schools require that.
That's right.
I went in on Saturday to drop off newspapers, and I had a group from Greenville High, Mann, Greenville Tech Charter High School, and Eastside in my volunteer workroom. So none of these kids knew each other, but they all loved animals and volunteered, and they had a whole, it was like a secondary group of friends that they had now because they had volunteered at the Humane Society.
That's wonderful. Well, you've brought so much love and encouragement and enthusiasm to what you do, Kim, and it's made a big difference.
Well, we appreciate the fact that you're a fan. So we like having Peggy Denny as a fan. That's a good thing.
I'm going to come out there between now and Christmas.
Good.
I'm going to see what's going on.
We hope so.
This little friend.
Well, Santa's asleep in your lap, so that's very special.
This is Rudy.
That's Rudy, named by the Greenville Tech Charter High School students today.
And Rudy wants a home. And I don't think he's going to grow up to be a great big dog.
No, he's an Australian Shepherd mix, so he'll be probably 60 pounds. But he's a good dog. He's been very even-tempered today. This is stressful to come on a TV show when you're only 8 weeks old. Imagine.
I know. Well, he's adorable. And I thank you for
coming
and sharing.
Thank you for having us. Thank you for spreading the word.
One more time, here we are. If you want to honor somebody, this is as little as $5 you can give, and this will be sent to them that they have been remembered in a special way, and the money will go to the Greenville Humane Society. That's a lovely thing.
Yeah. Well, thank you. Our staff made these, so they're pretty proud, and these are adoptable animals, so it's special.
Kim, you're an amazing woman.
Thank you for letting us be here
at Christmas
time.
I hope you'll come back soon.
We love coming to your
show. And I wish Santa Claus would say goodbye.
But he's rallying.
You stay happy, and we'll see you next time.